This is a production of PBS 39.
Well, here's some information that might startle you. Compared to breast cancer, which affects 1 in 8 women, ovarian cancer affects 1 in 70. Yet ovarian cancer is the leading cause of death in gynecological cancers. The reason? It's a difficult disease to detect. But there's a new treatment available at Lehigh Valley Hospital, and it's recognized as the gold standard to beat what doctors have coined the silent killer. Katie Fehlinger has the story.
Sibylla Lightcap's like a kid in a candy store at a greenhouse. She enjoys wandering the aisles, stopping to check out some of her favorite houseplants. But she's mostly interested in the fresh African violets.
I guess I'm raising violets because my mother raised violets.
The avid gardener loves picking up fresh plants and watching them grow.
Well, I like to see the results of gardening, how you nourish it along and eventually get to see them bloom.
Sibylla's seen something else bloom in recent years, her own health.
It took years for me to get back into full swing and to feeling like I am today, of course.
She's doing very, very well now and has the problems that she initially experienced. They're more or less a bad memory at this point.
The bad memories started for Sibylla when she noticed a pinching in her abdomen about 6 years ago.
The fact that I had the pain, I figured something was wrong. It was an unusual pain that I didn't have before.
She was shocked when her doctors diagnosed her with ovarian cancer. This scan shows a typical case. It's how Sibylla's cancer spread. All that dark gray area is tumor.
Cancer, by definition, is the unrestricted growth of cells. So a cell goes through a cell cycle and it starts to divide. And 1 leads to 2, leads to 4, leads to 8, and it divides exponentially.
If you think about a delicate flower like a mum, when the wind blows, the petals scatter. That's pretty much how ovarian cancer spreads. The cancer cells flake off and travel to different parts of the body where they attach. That's when the cancer becomes advanced. And unfortunately, it's also when most patients just start to notice symptoms.
Our research indicates that it's because many women, unfortunately, are not aware of the signs and symptoms.
The reason the mortality rate is so high or the death rate is so high is because we find the disease at such a late stage.
Just how high? About 16,000 women die from the disease annually nationwide. Of the 25,000 diagnosed every year, 3/4 of those women present or receive a diagnosis between stages 3 and 4, the most advanced stages of the cancer.
Yes.
Sibylla presented at stage 3.
I didn't know if I was going to make it or not.
She immediately underwent surgery to remove as much of the tumor as possible. Then Sibylla talked over further treatment options with her doctor to get rid of the cancer for good. Rick Boulay, a gynecological oncologist at Lehigh Valley Hospital, introduced her to a clinical trial going on at the time for a treatment called intraperitoneal chemotherapy, or IP.
I was kind of hesitant at first, but then I thought, well, I'd go along with the study to help other women who were in the same situation, had the same prognosis that I did.
Other women like Molly Morosky. She's going through her second of 6 rounds of IP. Basically, it works like this. In addition to the typical intravenous chemotherapy, Molly has a second IV, the intraperitoneal, to provide a more concentrated treatment. It runs directly into her abdomen where the tumors spread. But with more chemo comes more side effects.
And those side effects included more pain because we give about a 1/2 gallon of fluid into the belly when we give the chemotherapy, so that's stretching pain.
Patients tend to feel more nauseous and have more numbness in their hands and feet as well. And as with regular chemotherapy, patients lose their hair. But for Molly, it's a small price to pay.
That's the least of my worries right now. I just want to get myself back together again. That's it.
Molly says she owes a lot to her team of doctors, specifically her main attending oncologist, Martin Martino.
Good morning.
He's not afraid to hug you. He's not afraid to hold your hand. Like, he's just been wonderful. Thank God.
Molly gave him this special gift in appreciation, a stuffed horse she named M&M, after Dr. Martino's and her own initials.
I'll put it in my office.
Okay, please do that. So that way when you look at that, you remember me all the time.
Just a day earlier, Tempo got to witness when a special visitor came to see Molly. She got to meet someone who'd gone through the treatment, too.
You look wonderful.
Well, thank you.
Your hair grew back and nice.
They laughed a little.
My spirits are like really high now just from meeting her, seeing how good she looks and everything. Hopefully 6 years down the road, I'll like her.
And cried.
You'll make it.
I'll be, oh yeah. Take the hands off of it. Right?
Gotta make it.
I'll be good.
Thanks to women like Sibylla who participated in the trials, the National Cancer Institute issued an alert at the beginning of 2006 that IP chemotherapy is now the preferred treatment for ovarian cancer.
You must know how brave we all think you are.
And the results look more promising, too. The overall cure rate has increased 25%, and patients live an average of 16 months longer. And even though the chemo's side effects are worse,
we find that their quality of life is equal. So it seems to be a short-term loss for a long-term gain.
For most women, symptoms persist for a while. In its early stages, ovarian cancer is very tough to detect because it mimics many non-cancerous conditions. So what should you look for?
They generally have symptoms of persistent abdominal bloating. They feel like they can't finish a meal because they get full too quickly.
Women sometimes think they're gaining weight when in actuality they're gaining cancer cells and fluid.
Other symptoms to watch for: vaginal bleeding or irregular menstruation cycles, abdominal or pelvic pain, and any change in your bowel habits. Some factors that can increase your risk: never getting pregnant, early onset menstruation, and late onset menopause. These factors all give the ovaries more chances to cause genetic mutations of cells, which can lead to cancer.
They have, my friends from work send me bouquets, like I get one like every other day or whatever.
As for Molly, she's taking her own advice. Though she fell off the horse, she's getting right back on with the help of her doctors. For Tempo, I'm Katie Fehlinger reporting.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers. And workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39, thank you.